Dear colleague, today I will speak about snapping anterior shoulder pain. Causes, usually the causes of snapping anterior shoulder, structures like subscapularis tendon, osology. Calcification of subscapularis tendon can cause impingement under the coracoid during sternal rotation, like subscapularis tendon calcification, subscapularis tendon ganglion cyst, subcoracoid bursitis with synovial hypertrophy causing impingement during internal and external rotation. Subscapularis bursa, which is deep to the subscapularis tendon, also can cause snapping anterior shoulder. Other causes, which is the case of today, is the subacromial subdeltoid bursa, bursitis with synovial hypertrophy, causing impingement under the coracoacromial ligament during internal external rotation of subscapularis tendon with abduction and flexion of the shoulder. This will bring the synovial hypertrophy villi tissue under the coracoacromial ligament during flexion abduction combined with internal rotation and external rotation. Other causes of snapping anterior shoulder is the pathology of the biceps tendon long head, usually subluxation, dislocation, sheath bursitis, impingement under the coracoacromial ligament, also one of the causes. Today is a case of 40 years old female teacher. So she is using abduction, flexion, and writing on tab and the table. So all this movement can cause bursitis, and during flexion abduction combined with internal rotation can cause impingement, as we'll see by dynamic sonography. We know that dynamic sonography is superior to MRI because you can see the possible tissues, which is the subacromial subdeltoid bursa, hypertrophy, and the snapping and the bulging of it. Now you will see during external and internal rotation, this is a coracoid. This is the coracoacromial ligament from the coracoid. And you can observe the synovial tissue here, causing bulging, pushing the coracoacromial ligament and bulging here. The impingement not under the coracoid, but the impingement occur here. You can see the synovial tissue hypertrophy, and this is a coracoacromial ligament. You can see it. Now I will start my procedure. You can see the needle approach coming. I will dissect the bursa at the site of the impingement to place my injectant under guidance of the ultrasound. You can see here is a needle coming from lateral approach, directed slightly upward towards the medial side. Then you use the jet of the injectant to hydrodissect the subacromial subdeltoid bursa. Here's the adductor cuff interval. Then you seek the site of impingement here. You can see the distension of the bursa with the injectate. This is show a successful dynamic ultrasound showing the cause of impingement, which is under the coracoacromial ligament, and ultrasound guided treatment for the impingement with complete relief.